Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, welcome to VWF Nitro. This year is truly the JM Factor, Joseph Montes. And we're going to hear our opening contest as Roddy Vick will be taking on VWF's resident underdog, Hinata. And guys, if you guys didn't tune in last week, and if you didn't, well, shame on you. Go back, press the back button right now, and go watch episode 6. And I can't believe that Fred would willingly put his ownership of VWF on the line in the War Games. I mean, after the show, when Fred made that, I literally, like, got up, I ran all the way to the Hall of Justice, and I was like, Fred, what the hell are you doing, man? Do you have any idea what you're doing here? You know, you are aware of what will happen if you lose, right? You do understand this. And he was like, yeah, man, I was trying to talk Fred out of it. I was trying to reason with him. And he won't back out of this, and I got a really bad feeling about this whole War Games thing. I mean, I can't believe he would willingly put the fate of VWF ownership on the line in that match. And Ami just tried to talk him out of it, and Ami kind of, like, pretty much I agree with what she's saying. I'm like, God. Well, except the ignoring part. But it just doesn't sit right. Now, Fred's got himself back into a corner right now. If the Senshi now demoralized and really not in sync, this could be trouble. Meanwhile, here comes Vita's resident underdog, Hinata, making her way to the ring. Hinata going to be taking on a very dangerous, very hardcore, one who doesn't really play by the rules, Roddy Rikku. You may still see that scar on Roddy Rikku's eyes, clear as day. Roddy Rikku's whole change when back she was raised, she got face first right into the windshield by the Winter Sisters. And here we go, sound of the bell, the match is underway. Right now having a feel, starting out with a feel out process. And Rikku just throwing her off. She just taunting Hinata, just trying to get her riled up. Yuna clan very calm, very demeanor. Hinata rushing in with strikes. And Roddy Rikku blocking. I mean, Hinata may have speed and precision with her hit with her fists. But Roddy Rikku in the streets. Well, quick, she's going to be relying on many different tactics to get that win. And Hinata outsmarting Roddy Rikku right there with the bulldog. Juking strike right to the midsection for the scoop and the slam, twisting her body a little bit to add more force to it. Big roundhouse kick, right here, just pulling it right into a roundhouse kick, and then luring some elbows. Big spinning drop kick. Right. Hinata dazed. Atomic drop, your ass is gonna be broken. Big Frankenstein right now, right here, go in the driver's seat right now, definitely dominating Hinata. Wait, Hinata with the back body drop to the outside. And Hinata, oh god, look out. Air Yuga coming. And I can quote my friend Eddie Mack. He was like, "You pay double you pay more for extra for a flight movie." I don't know if I even said it right. Forgive me for that, Eddie. And a referee counting 20 count rules in VWF. Right now, Hinata is in trouble because Roddy Rikku has more of an advantage outside the ring. There's more toys to play with to put people through. Since Roddy Rikku doesn't want to risk the DQ, even knowing her. She'd probably be like, screw the DQ, I'm going to do it anyway. And you know it too, because that's her style. I'm going to just drive big elbow. Last time we saw Roddy Rikku, ladies and gentlemen, if you don't remember, was last season when she was against Dixie Clements in that steel cage match. And we definitely know there's some issues, there's still stuff unresolved with that too. Yeah, it could be in trouble here. One, two, no. Hinata still has some fight left. Look at that! Big sass press and dropping in those hammer fists. Those juking strikes right to the forehead. And more juking strikes right to the forehead and right to the temple. But right here he goes way too stubborn to be like down, out, and paralyzed. And oh wait, look at this. Hinata, big power bomb! Right here his back is killing, must be killing him right now. That from that power bomb, I didn't realize I see a power bomb from Hinata. That was pretty impressive. Yeah, I wonder if she was basically taunting Roddy Rekha, you know, Roddy Rekha with the master of the Sunset Driver and the Fallen Angel. Once again, just taunting Roddy Rekha. I think she's calling for end game. Fallen Angel! And there it is. Leg hook. One, two, oh man, Hinata kicking out of the Fallen Angel. I thought Hinata was done for as soon as that connected. Now, just, oh my god, surfboard stretch right on the eight on the ropes. Man, surfboard stretch, man, working on the shoulders as well as the spine. Knee to the midsection, famouser. Not in a whole lot of trouble. Referee in position, one, two, no. You know, another thing, ladies, only gotta wonder is, wait before I go into that, into a cradle, one, two, three. Oh my god, Hinata beat Roddy Rekha. Hinata, with a roll-up, beat Roddy Rekha. I can't believe it. I didn't see that coming. Let's see this again in the highlights. Roddy Rekha with the Fallen Angel. She had the leg hook. Hinata barely kicking out. It had to be like 2.9. Over here, this is where there's the knee to the midsection followed by the famouser. Hinata barely kicking out of that pin. And then right there, into a roll-up, Roddy Rekha shocked, didn't see that coming, and Hinata with the win. One of the very veterans, and even a former SCA Women's Champion. Big win for Hinata, but if I were her, I would kind of get out of the ring. Case Roddy Rekha, shakes the cobwebs out, she's probably gonna go beat the crap out of Hinata. So Hinata, I run right now. Meanwhile, there's Rinoa. Rinoa's still frosty about what happened last week. Well, if Rinoa wants to do that, she's going to need to find a tag team partner. Meanwhile, at the Hall of Justice. Well, Frey just used the morale booster, and he de-hammers Minako. She's like, do I have a choice? And he's basically like, nope. Minako just got noped into helping the Senshi. But it's either this, you either help the Senshi and make sure Fred still keeps his job, or not help the Senshi, and Mio takes control of the company. And meanwhile, the greatest of all time finally makes her presence in the ring. We gotta wonder some why, but the weird thing was, during Erza's match last week, if you guys don't remember, Lightning came out and did some praise, and I'm wondering why. Like, she has an interest in Erza. Maybe curiosity, I guess. Wondering. Anyway, Lightning will be facing Melina, and what drives me crazy more than anything is, how's Melina still employed? You know, that's the one mystery, guys, I'm never gonna find out is, how's Melina still here and still having a job? I'm like, what? Weren't you murder, death, kill last season? And then you came back and you were like, I think if I go too much into it, I'm probably gonna hurt my head. I'd rather not do that. Alright, anyway. Alright, so having a nice drink of water, here we go, Salad Bell, and the match is underway. Lightning telling Melina straight up, I'm the greatest, you must respect me, and Melina's like, nah, I'm not respecting you. And I was like, this is what happens when you don't respect me, Russian leg sweep. The Russian leg sweep, I have a new line for it. It is so powerful that it bends the very fabric of the universe itself. And Melina, oh god, me! Right to the jaw. And even Lightning, the greatest, must respect the knee. Melina punches, knife edges. Lightning having a little bit of difficulty at the moment. We all Lightning bouncing back. Jab. Frankensteiner. Why? Because if I probably say, if I accidentally call the Hurricanrana, Scott Steiner will probably, like, bash my locker room door open with a pipe. And be like, why the hell you keep calling it that? It's a Frankensteiner! And you say it again, I'll bash you with the pipe! I guarantee you he'll do that. Meanwhile, Lightning is taking Melina, oh god, Inzaghi. The back of your skull will be hurting. Lightning just throwing Melina. Lightning even trying to shoulder tackle her out, and Melina literally, well, outsmarting Lightning. Now here we go, battling it outside the ring, right by my broadcast position. I still need to talk to Fred to see if I can get my own, if I can call things the action on my very own skybox, like I do in SEN. Yeah, every time my table somehow breaks, the anime I buy will end up everywhere on the floor. It's more of a hassle to clean up. And Lightning throwing Melina back in the apron. Oh, elbow right to the... That was to the forehead, man. That was to the eye. He's trying to make Melina go blind. Lightning so far controlling the match. Melina already having difficulty. Lightning just after Lightning bounced back and there was an elbow shot by Melina. Oh man. Oh, I think Melina could be ending this right now. I think we could have an early end here. Lightning is like dazed. And Melina's like, she's like, nope. That time was hurt with the heads. Now, Lightning up on top. The army of one. Lightning with the army of one. One, two, oh, forget about it. It is over. The greatest. Melina, even Melina, must bow down to the greatest Final Fantasy character of all time. all of you would put your hands to your chest and be like, the greenest. And look at that, army one, beautiful, beautifully executed, one, two, and three, and that was all she wrote. Lady with another great victory, and oh, wait a minute. There's a plot of Lightning? I mean, Lightning did the same last week. Well, what would be Erza's reasoning? Wait, hold on a minute. Lightning's grabbing a microphone. If she did win that, she did earn it last season. And she really is the greatest Final Fantasy character of all time. I'm kind of curious. Oh, you got it. You gonna go there? Even though I did look this up, 13-13-2 actually did sell pretty well here in America. I actually did look this up. You don't believe me? Look it up yourselves too. Oh, Lightning wants Erza and WarGames. Wizards, Lightning, War Games. That's going to be pretty interesting. Ha! Lightning got you there. And that the War Games, it's going to be more about pride. It's going to be all about respect. Say she's gonna make Lightning tap, but I doubt that. Good luck with that, Erza. Guys, mark that on your list for War Games matches. The battle for respect. Meanwhile, there's a Harkin Shear at the meeting place. Man, Haruka went to go hunt down the Winter Sisters, who are getting in my earpiece right now that they're not even in the building. Man, talk about standing up for a meeting. And the one thing I know, you never, like, not show up to a meeting. Then the person who doesn't show up to the meeting, the next day they're gonna go get the ass kicked. I've seen that happen a few times. Right, now here come the Gullwings. Here comes Yuna and Rikku reunited. It seems Rikku is seeing things from Yuna's perspective. Now, and I got a feeling we probably might see a big difference between Rikku as she was with Rinoa and Rikku now that she's back together with Yuna. Rikku wanted more. Now she's with Yuna, and once again, the Gullwings are back involved in the tag team circuit. And who better to test this against? The incredible crash dummies, the Gears of War, who are in the bottom of the barrel, in the bottomless pit, where a team that will never reach tag team status, the incredible crash dummies, Anya and Sam. No, real, I'm actually considering them that now. Tune-up match! I'm calling it the tune-up match. Sam and Ani gonna try to get themselves out of this funk in this tune-up. Alright, here we go. It's gonna be Rikku and Sam gonna be starting this off first. The Gears of War have been stuck at the bottom of the bottomless pit in the tag team circuit for quite since last season, actually. After being buried and destroyed by the Winter Sisters and everybody else. Only getting some wins, but not a lot. And just getting up in Sam's face, and here we go, collar elbow. I will say that Rikku might need to be a little bit careful, though. Because if there's one thing that the Gears have over Rikku, that's going to be strength. Rikku has speed and Yuna has technique. And here goes Sam setting Rikku up for a ride. Picking up back body drop. Yeah, punching Rikku right into the corner. Turning around. Shoulder thrust right to the mid, to the gut. And Rikku with the knee. Even Sam must respect the knee. The knee is the most powerful weapon in the world. The knee saves lives. The knee defies all logic and gravity. Hell. And the knee is a great weapon in Muay Thai. I should know, I practiced Muay Thai back in junior high. Elbow by Rikku. Rikku now grabbing Sam, throwing her, pulling her right back into a neck breaker. She actually trolled and actually tricked Sam right there. Now throwing her right into the Gullwings corner. Now here goes Yuna. Center for a ride. Double flapjack. He was a former women's champion back in the old NGW days. Oh, only one. Driving her right into a monkey flip. Things right now are going the Gullwings way right now. Nightbed's chop. And now throwing Sam down, and she's going up. She's going up top. What does Yuna have in mind here? Front missile drop kick. Right to the chest. 1, 2. Oh man, that was actually a 2.9. Sam fighting Yuna back with her own powerful drop kick, making a tap, making going to the corner, making tagging in a fresh Anya. Here we go. Drop toe hold. Elbow. These two need to work on their tag team symmetry, unity. Big hip toss. And I'm just delivering elbows to those shoulders. Trying to do as much damage to Yuna as possible. Kick to the knee. And I'm just grabbing her by her hair and slamming in the back of her head into the canvas. Punch her into the ropes. Forearm. To the back. Attacking back in Sam. Getting Sam the opening. Now he's grabbing Yuna by her hair again and he's slamming the back of her head into the mat. lifting her up. Vertical suplex. Plunge! The Fist of Fury. Right now this crowd wants the gears to actually get out of this bottomless pit. And now Anya, once again delivering more Fists of Fury to Yuna. Yuna in a little bit of trouble right now. And you get a side headlock. Picking her up. Back suplex. Gears making so many mistakes right now. They should be capitalizing on the fact that Yuna's in trouble instead of taunting to these fans. And that could cost it right there. There's the great equalizer. Right to the eye. Rikku being tagged in. Get to the midsection. Double DDT. Big mistake by Anya. And now she's going to be paying the price. There's a hurricanrana in. One, two. Oh, man, I was so close to three. Gears in trouble. I mean, thrown into the corner. Plunge! Now, what's Rikku up to? Rikku, tornado DDT. Drilling Anya's head into the mat. And here we go, cover. One, two. No, only two. And yeah, with a very provocative slap. And here it is. Oh, man. Chest breaker. That knee into the chest. And once again, got her over the shoulder. Another chest breaker. That's two chest breakers. I told you, the knee defies all logic. It will break through armor. Now tagging in Yuna. And even more double DDTs. Driving the back of the neck right into those ropes. Now tagging in Rikku again. Gullwings really been in control of this match. You actually see the difference between when Rikku is with Rinoa and Rikku when she's now with the reunited with her cousin. And flapjack! And Rikku could be calling for the end. She's gonna finish up Anya. Here we go! That alternate version of the Elbow Drop. Two! Three, forget about it. Flawless victory for the Gullwings. What a difference, a big difference. And the Gears will still be in that bottomless pit of destruction where they will never come back up from ever again. There's that alternate version of the Elbow Drop. And one, two, three, and it was done. The Gullwings are back in the tag team circuit. But if they want those tag team titles, it's going to be a big mountain to climb. the hell VWF has an app? Since when? You can find all this out and more, ladies and gentlemen, on the VWF app. Screw Tower. You join the VWF app. Go on your phone right now for the app. Here's Panty and Stock. Wow, and if you want to see that, you don't really pay double for that kind of action, but if you want to see that action, you must download the VWF app. You must go download the VWF app right now. Go on your phone right now and get the VWF app. Put it on your Vita, your PSP, your anything. And Stocky just ruined Panty's moment. He's got no Panty. Alright, so anyway, who's going to be taking their open challenge? Look who's right for sore eyes. It's Xiaoyu's still hurt and still sore from that loss, from the past couple of losses she's had. Xiaoyu has not had the greatest of starts here in VWF. She had her ass beat by Chun-Li, not once, but twice. And she had her ass beat by Samus. Yeah, I wonder, who is going to be Xiaoyu's tag team partner? And will Xiaoyu have better luck in the tag team circuit than she is in the singles division right now? It would have been worse. I mean, she could have been fed to Gina Carano. We would have new grave filled up. We could have more graves to fill in the back of the building. It looks like Sakura is going to be teaming up with Xiaoyu against Panty and Stocky. Sakura's going to be living her chakra fists of death to the Anarchy Sisters. Sakura was also one of the main victims of Gina Carano. She was in one of the graves, and then when GCF got derailed, she dug herself out of the grave. Look at that look on Panty's face. Panty just wants to... She so wants to give the 69er pile driver so badly on Sakura right now. Nice review. It's going to be Xiaoyu and Stocking starting things off first. Panty and Stocking have been making a huge impact in the tag team circuit right now. Big victories. Will we make it 3-0 today? I don't know. We're about to find out right now. Stocking with the preemptive strike. And Xiaoyu still trying to bounce back for the past few losses she's acquired lately. Trying to stick with punches. Stocking getting the better of Xiaoyu right now. I'll try to go for a grab now. Face crusher by Xiaoyu. Xiaoyu with the big running shoulder thrust. And now grabbing. Stocking pulling it right into a backbreaker. Now going, rebounding off the ropes. Dropping the big splash, but didn't go for a cover. He's got to go for the cover whenever he had the opportunity. Stocking literally punching Xiaoyu so hard that she made her fly out the ring. Oh, Panty's got her hands on her. And hey, he's throwing Xiaoyu right back in the ring and dropping a big elbow for her trebles. Xiaoyu with the knee to the midsection. Xiaoyu actually finding an opening here, delivering a kick! And it was a savat kick. Another elbow right to the back of the head, and pinning Stocking right into the corner. Turning for another knife edge. Stocking, countering that. And now she has Xiaoyu pinned down to the corner. And wait, now Xiaoyu has Stocking pinned down to the corner. Gotta go for something Stocking bringing out of it. Rinoa thrown over DDT. Panty and Stocking in control. And Stocking to give a tornado DDT for her troubles. With tax. One. Two. No, only two count. Big roundhouse kick by Xiaoyu, and now Xiaoyu, I thought she was, wow, for a second, I honestly thought she was going to make the tag to Sakura. And here we go, Sakura's been tagged in. The lead, the Konoha's medic in the field, in the battlefield. And now just doing some damage, into the hamstrings. Sakura can deliver chakra power this. There's a big belly-to-belly suplex. And it's not just working on the arm of Stocking, just grabbing it. And Reggie trying to rip it out like this was Mortal Kombat. And Stocking screaming in pain, screaming in agony. I think it's going to take more than that to put Stocking away. Nice tilt-a-roll side slam counter by Stocking. Stocking needs to make that tag to Panty. There we go. There goes Panty. Panty's now the legal woman. It's time for Air Panty, the Wagon Launcher. You better pay for our drinks and some snacks for that in-flight movie. Try to go for a discus clothesline area. Elbow. Front face lock. And now setting Sakura up for a ride. Panty's definitely thinking about giving Sakura the 69er pile driver. Sakura already troubled, oh god, are we gonna see her? It's Sakura, and Panty, with the pile driver! Vicious! One, two, no. That was definitely close to a three. Panty, blocking the double axe hand. And now picking her up, into a suplex! And slamming the arm, right into the mat. Running off the ropes, dropping the elbow right to the stomach. Trying for a drop kick to the knee, but missed. And Sakura now taking immediate advantage of that mistake. There's one thing you don't want to make mistakes around Sakura. Now Xiaoyu is now the legal woman. Double hit toss, double elbow. And they both literally tip up back up. And now here goes Xiaoyu delivering fists of fury to Panty. Xiaoyu wants to get out of this losing streak that she's in right now. Side headlock takedown. Now setting. Throwing Panty into the corner. Dropping the shoulder. And a big lariat. Leg hook. One, two. The only two can. Holding the arm. Stretching the arm and dropping the leg. Trying to make it harder for Panty to try to attempt the 69er pile driver. Another kick, Stocking, with an elbow. And Panty, once again, pile driver. Just dropping it right on her head. Big power slam, leg hook, one, two, no, not enough, it was damn well close. Now tagging Stocking back in. Double gut buster. Xiaoyu literally being dominated. Another power slam. Everyone's getting power slams. And dropping the elbow again. Knee. Man, a lot of people haven't been respecting the knee today. Try to go for something. No, Xiao Yu with the counter into the bulldog. But she's stubbornly not making the tag, which is not a smart thing. Oh wait, what's this? Finisher! Stocky! What a finisher! One, two, three! No, oh man, I thought that was a three, but that was damn well close. Oh, Stocky in trouble. Stocky, wait a minute. No, Stocky with a counter. Stocky with that reverse DDT. And now here comes Panty. Uh-oh. Panty. Oh, God. There it is, ladies and gentlemen. The 69er pile driver. One, two. Oh, forget about it. It is over. It was a niner. It's 69er. Even Xiao Yu is not safe from the 69er pile driver. There's that power, that modified power slam pin. Here's some of the mini double teams. The double check up, double gut buster. And here it was, ladies and gentlemen, the 69er pile driver. Xiao Yu will never be the same. And that's three wins in a row for Panty and Stocky. You still can't recover from the effects of the 69er pile driver.
Hey everybody, this is the owner of Vixen's Wrestling Federation, Freddie J. Francis, letting you know that we have the official VWF Wiki page. Where you can find it in our wiki? Well, you can find history of all of our events and championships, in-depth Nitro episodes, and the entire roster and staff for you to check out. We are constantly updating, so check us out at vixenswf.wikia.com.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. It's main event time. The Daughters of Darkness are here. Intergalactic Champion. The Hardcore Champion. Mephisto's been going around calling her, saying that she is the woman that ended the GCF. That ended the Gina Carano Federation. You gotta wonder, who will the Senshi choose for this handicap match? Look at Neo. There's the fearless leader. Neo's saying that we're the future of the VWF. She's saying that I'm the savior. I will get rid of Fred, which is what she's saying. And make myself the owner. I will damn the VWF with some crazy shit. Oh, Mia grabbing a mic. This isn't gonna be good. Who's gonna be the victim? God, what is the decision? Looks like Minato is going to be modding the rules a little bit. Counter booking. Mio's pissed! She's yelling in the microphone! She is pissed! Who will be Minato's partner for this tag team main event? And it's Rey. Looks like Minato and Rey are going to be taking on the Fisto and X-23. Man, did you see how Neo is freaking out when Minato said that Fred will be allowing him to change the rule set? And Neo had a well thought out plan, probably wanted to take the Senshi out early to make the odds even greater for them for the WarGames match. But fortunately, that was not meant to be. Fred put his foot down. It has helped the Senshi even the odds a little bit. But even with the odds even out, it's still not going to be that easy. If Dawns of Darkness have been going roughhouse on everybody in VWF, they have the majority of the gold. All they're missing are the tag team titles. That's if they even wanted the tag team titles. Alright, here we go. Rey better be a little bit cautious here. If Dark's Darkness has been playing guerrilla tactics on the Senshi, and Mio, X-23, going outside, going to Mio for advice. She's telling him, I want you to go out there in that ring. I want you to destroy the Senshi. I want you to destroy them. Give them the Peacekeeper all the way to hell. And Minako and Rey are going to have to be very careful. They have to have eyes in the back of their head because Mio is right out there stalking, watching, waiting. Right, Mio's arguing with the fans right now. Meanwhile, back in the ring. Big route being eaten security by Rey. And now, X-23 with the counter. No, Rey with the counter. Rey with the spinning head scissors takedown. The Senshi are reunited, at least for a time. Are united, but can they still work together? But they might have, but they might not have a choice. If they want to make sure that Fred stays in power and not have Mio and the Daughters of Darkness have control. Can you imagine a public what would happen if Mio and the Daughters of Darkness would take control of VWF? Man, I've been thinking about it, man. It could be a catastrophe, a public relations nightmare. It will not be what is best for business. Yes, I just used that line. And X-23 is literally snatching up Rey and slamming her Rey back down to the canvas. And Rey responds in kind. The Senshi aren't gonna give up. They're not gonna quit. They're not gonna rest until they get the Daughters of Darkness out of VWF. Knife edge. More knife edges. Look at Mio. I see Mio getting very frustrated. Back suplex by Minako. Away with Mio getting on the apron. But technically the ref can't do anything. She isn't anything. And she's not doing anything illegal. But there's a big overhead release by X-23. And now Minako pinned in the corner. No, X-23 held on for the back body drop. But got shoulder thrusted out of the ring. The referee administering the count. Alright, extra three. Heading back in the ring, Minako idiotically, like an idiot, dropped their guard and ate a big old drop kick. Now extra three grabbing Minako, throwing her right back into their corner. Shoulder thrust. Now making the tag to Mephisto, the Intergalactic Champion, the hardcore anime, who planted that big body shot. Mephisto doing everything around. Oh, here, belly to back suplex. Minako trying to shoot the cobwebs out. Mephisto. This stupid delivering. Those clubbing blows. Those clubbing blows across the chest. And what the hell? Those clubbing blows were so powerful that Mephisto used the logic of anime and made a pocket dimension swallow up Minako and then opened the pocket dimension so Minako can appear back in the ring. Amazing. The power of anime logic. Just trying for a front dropkick. Minako with the counter. You see Mio literally cursing out Minako. Mio trying to do something, anything to get the Senshi's attention off the her members, off her associates, and so far it ain't working out. Spinning heel kick by Ray, and Ray delivering kicks to the hamstring, dropkick right to the back, and Mephisto's face hit the turnbuckle, and dropping a big knee into the lower back. And Neo just got booted off the island. And the referee keeping an eye out on Neo. Next one, he's delivering that cheap shot. DDT. Man, the odds are great against the Senshi right now. And I'm making the tag back to X23. Double Russian leg sweep, the move that defies all logic. And X-Trinity now setting Ray up for a ride. Counter by Ray. Ray still has a more fight in her than I thought. X-Trinity shoves it. X-Trinity's like, yeah. And Ray's like, yeah, back. Ultra over at clothesline, another counter, another arm drag counter. Ray in control. Kick to the midsection. Sunset flip power. One, two. No. Pulling right back into a heel kick. Driving the moonsault. Springboard vaulting body press, no. Elbow to the back of the head by X23, that's her rebuttal. And now dropping the fist. And making the tag back to Mephisto. Mephisto once again with the big body shot. It's a big clubbing shot to the back of the neck. And now Mephisto just knee right to the face. A lot of people are getting knee today. One, two, no. Senshi, gotta do something here to try to turn this around. STO. Mia's getting so frustrated, I think she took apart my table. Yeah, I can see the frustration. Mia literally, like, took apart my table, guys. She's like, ah! And now Mephisto, tagging in X23, rocket launcher. And the Donuts of Darkness in the driver's seat. They are destroying the Senshi. And if this was an amateur wrestling match, X23 would have gotten 2 points. Oh, Oh. Not good. The Peacekeeper! And wait a minute! Ray got back onto her feet! Ray ate that for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And there's the flame shooter. And look at Mio. Distracting the referee. She is distracting the official. And X-Ray is going to be taking advantage of the distraction with that backbreaker. Now tagging back in Lufisto. Big clubbing shot. Now dropping that elbow. Oh god, Codebreaker. Double knee to the face. One, two. Oh man, that was definitely close. Mio giving Lufisto some advice. Lufisto using the power of anime logic to protect herself and Mio, but Mio didn't apply to Mio as much. Running drop kick in the corner. Lufisto pinned down, and there it is, the Flame Buster. Throwing her into the ropes. Ray now tagging Minako right back in. Double gut buster. Big double teams by both. And the referee telling Ray, get back in the corner. Minako with a series of forearm shots. Death press. Delivering two powerful strikes. Float over neck breaker. You can see the frustration. Oh my god! She clotheslined Mio right into the face versus the barricade. Another float over neck breaker. And Lufisto kills all that momentum. Wait, Lufisto going up top. She's up for something dastardly. Front missile drop kick. My god. Making the tag. Got her. Double gut buster again. NX23. She's signaling for the end. Turn for jabs. For crosses. She has Minako pinned in the corner. Try to fight back with knife edge, with punches, with lefts and rights. Front face lock. Backbreaker. Naga's still in this thing. I'll try to do a hard shot. X23 missed. There it is. DDT. X23 countering with a DDT. Oh no, I think she's going to do it again. No. Forearm shot by Minako. And X23 again with that DDT. And they're right up to a back suplex. Tagging in Lufisto. God, Senshi. A lot of trouble right now. It's not looking good for the Senshi at the moment. We're not going to fight for dear life. Flatjack on the ropes. Vicious Larry. There's a German suplex with a bridge. One. Oh man, Ray able to break it up. How much more do these four have? And oh wait a minute, Lufisto. Inverted Death Valley Driver. One, two, three. Oh, forget about it, it's over. It's a wrap. The Dawn of the Darkness with another big win. My God, every week, every freaking week, the Dwarves of Darkness have been one-upping the Senshi. The Senshi tried, and everything they tried to do against them has failed. My God, and wait a minute, and look at this, look at this! The Daughters of Darkness are continuing, they're not done with Minako yet. They're gonna finish what they started. Oh my God, someone has to stop this. Man, where is security? And wait a minute! Here comes Ami, Ami to the rescue. Kick, discus punch, punch! She's got her hands on X23, putting the boots to her. Mio quickly retreating. Wait, what the hell? The lights just went out! Where the hell is my flashlight? Damn, where is this thing? Flashlight. Damn, it's dark in here! And, oh my God! Oh my God! It's Aaron! Ami, look out! Aaron, oh no! Oh no! She just chokeslammed! Oh God! Ami just got chokeslammed all the way to the depths of hell! Ladies and gentlemen, we're running out of time. We'll see you next week for Nitro.